Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn how to incorporate alcohols into our molecule names. So we have four molecules on the slide. I've named the first one. It's simply an alkene. This 6-methylheptene. It's a 7-carbon chain, and the alkene has priority as the highest priority functional group. So we number it with the alkene being as close to the end of the heptene chain as possible. And that gives us the heptene at the 1 position. Now let's stick an alcohol in this molecule. As it turns out, alcohols are higher priority than alkenes, so we number the chain according to the preference of the alcohol. So now the alcohol is closer to this end, so we will number from that end. And as we number down the chain, the alkene is now stuck at the 6th position. But we don't care how the alkene feels, because we are trying to satisfy the preferences of the alcohol. So now our methyl group is in the 2 position. This is 2-methyl. Now this is going to be a heptene all. Alcohols use the suffix O-L. So this is going to be a heptene all. And we're going to have, where is the alkene? The alkene is at the 6th position. Heptene, so the 6 refers to the alkene. And now we have to squeeze in a number for our alcohol. Heptenol. That's actually a fairly complicated example based on the ones that we've seen. Now you can have multiple alcohols in a molecule. Here's a butane, and we will number it so we hit one of the alcohols on the 1-carbon. This is going to be a butane diol. And where are the alcohols? Well, they're positions 1 and 3. Butane, and actually we keep the E so we don't have the N, the two consonants together. So it's butane diol, not butan diol without the E. So we keep that E so we can keep our consonants from bumping into each other. Now here's a molecule, this last molecule. We have 3 fluorines on this carbon. You might think, wow, 3 fluorines on that carbon. Maybe that's so important that we'll number from the fluorinated end of the molecule. No, we don't. The alcohol has top priority, whether it's 10 fluorines or 2 fluorines, or doesn't matter. It's one alcohol trumps however many fluorines or chlorines or bromines you might have. So this is going to have basically the same name as a previous example, except for on the 4-carbon, we're going to have 3 fluorines. And so we need 3 numbers, 4, 4, 4. And we indicate 3 fluorines by saying trifluoro. And then 1,3-butane diol. Note to separate our numbers, we use commas. To separate our letters and numbers, we use dashes or hyphens. So this is a simple application of alcohols. They're just a higher priority group, so we use the suffix O-L to indicate that we have an alcohol in the name, and then we apply the same rules as always.